Hey, guess what? I went into the treasure room, and I managed to find the blue rupee that decided to respawn, so I am at 1,000 rupees after all. Hello everyone, and welcome back to the walkthrough. Let's go! Face down the final boss and finish this walkthrough once and for all. Well, I shouldn't say for all, because some will be sad to see it go. I guess I'll be a little sad to see it go as well, since it's been on, you know, I've been working on this for months upon months now. But, as I said before, I am truly ready to get on with another game. Oh man. Oh man! By the way, if you look at your map... Oh, you can't look at your map, actually, because there's no map down there. I was gonna say, if you look at your map, it doesn't... This room doesn't match the size of the room that you've seen on the map when you came in here. In fact, you know what? I'm gonna see if I can leave and come back in here. No? Okay, well, you know what? You rewind the video and see for yourself. Anyway, I'm gonna go up the stairs. Let's get it on! By the way, everything is full. So I'm as good as I'll ever be to take on this final boss here. Oh, this is so exciting. Oh, who dares defile art such as that? Oh, there's Zelda. Still a prisoner, apparently. As you would expect. That's what happened to her, basically. She just got plopped over here somehow, I suppose. Why, thank you! For being the king of evil, he sure has nice manners. By the way, notice the wound on his chest there? That's still the wound from the... when he was about to be executed, when he got the sword through it. Petty magic, huh? Is that so? Excuse me. Excuse my mucus. So, the Ganondorf's Triforce of Power versus the Fused Shadows. Who will win? That is the question. And we will soon see. Oh, geez. Midna's, I mean, he's saying that Midna is basically keen on protecting this world as well. Go, Midna! And she couldn't stop him. In fact, he just went right around her. And is now inside Zelda, as you can see by Midna's reaction there. Oh! Oh, ninja! Thank you. Let's do it. And the final battle begins now. After a brief loading screen. This is Ganon's Puppet Zelda. And it's going to be something that's very familiar to you if you've played Ocarina of Time. Tennis! Oh, I blocked with my shield by mistake. I didn't swing the remote fast enough. I got to be further away from her in order to do this. Come on. Let's do it. Hooah! Oh, poopers. It's going to take me a bit to get the timing of this again. That's okay. On. And once I... There we go. And once I get enough hits in, you don't have to do anything else besides just doing that quick tennis match there. And once you do that enough times, this'll be done. Be wary of another attack. This one right here. When it glows like that, that's when you'll take damage from it, but that triangle, or triforce piece, whatever, that it's signaling there, you just have to get out of the triangle before it glows crazy-like, and then you'll be able to dodge the damage that it would happen to. It's not hard to do, so don't worry about it too much. Oh, I was a little early! How could I be so foolish? Probably because I am PkGam. And you can dodge that just by going like that. That's pretty much all the attacks that she has. Well, he has, because, you know, she's possessed by Ganondorf. Oops. Come on. Tennis match. Tennis match of the ancients. Come on. Or should I say tennis match of the gods? You have to wait for her to do it. There we go. Okay, no screwing up this time, PkGam. I don't know, screwing things up is your forte. By the way, Midna's still out there, in case you didn't notice that. Oh, there we go. Stay far enough away, I guess, you can anticipate the tennis ball of energy. Oh, there we go. We are doing well, I suppose. One more time, I think. Don't do that. What? That was weird. I never seen her do that before. She usually goes all the way to the other side of the room or loops in a wider circle than that. Oop. See, like that. That's what she normally does, but she just looped right around me. That was one of the weirdest actions I've ever seen happen during this battle. I was going to the corner, not toward the edge. That's a mistake. You always want to go towards the edge because there's less running room that you have to worry about. All right. Tennis. Come on. It gets a little bit faster and the speed changes, so that's why you want to have enough room in between, between you and her. Just to make sure that you can react properly. There we go. No problem. Oh yeah. Zelda's freed! But still KO'd. If you thought it was over, though, you are sadly mistaken. Phase 2. Starts. It's Ganon himself. And get out of the way quickly, by the way. For some reason, he jumps away before he charges at you, even though I'm sure he could do damage to you. Alright, so, munch your bow out. and wait for him to... Where is the portals? Okay, these portals. When one of those portals turns blue, you'll know he's coming out of one. And get your bull ready for it. There we go, like that. You know, I was a little bit late there, but that's what you want to do. And then hit the wound on his belly. Eventually, he's going to change patterns, and you're going to have to do it in wolf form. Well, do something similar in wolf form. But otherwise, the second part is pretty... Ah! Ninja! Dang you! Otherwise, the second part's pretty basic. You can only shoot him on his forehead when that thing on that light on his forehead is glowing. So keep that in mind as well. It only glows on certain times, like when he's charging directly at you. Where'd you... Oh, there you are. Glow, 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 glow. Yeah! I don't really care about taking damage as long as I just get a couple hits off him. I mean, just look at my health. Let's just look at things realistically here. And I've got so many potions, so I might as well do this in a nice, comfortable, speedy way. Otherwise, if you're trying to conserve health, you want to shoot him when he's further away from you. Oh! I think he just changes his attack pattern, so this is the time you want to transform into a wolf. Okay. Now, oh! Okay. Wait for it. The portal's gonna be somewhere around here. There? Maybe there? Okay. Lock on. Press A. And throw it like you would throw a goat. Seriously. And that's how it's done. Everything has come full circle. Yeah! Phase 2 is done. But it's not over yet. Not to spoil anything, but yeah, it's not over yet. I mean, come on, no, this is way too easy. Then again, the final boss of this game is generally easy overall. Uh-oh. What they're hinting at here is that the Triforce of Wisdom that Zelda, I believe, gave Midna over there to keep her alive went back over to Princess Zelda to revive her. Daw. But it all worked out. Well, it's not over yet, but still, it's gonna be. No. Now that's pretty sinister right there. Take him on, Midna! She transported us out of here to keep us safe. Uh-oh. Destroy him! And we're back in Hyrule Field. Way, way, way out in Hyrule Field. And there goes the castle. he's still alive. Yeah, that's basically why Midna transported us out of here, was because she knew that would happen if she unleashed all her power. But it wasn't enough. Oh, that is not a good sign. The few shadows are pretty much done for now. But we still have the Master Sword. Ooh. Teleportation always saves the day. I've said this before, but what can you do against a person that teleports? You can contain him and you can hit him, so yeah. And with the power of the Light Spirit, you get the final upgrade. Well, sort of. The Light Arrows. Basically, she's going to be using the Light Arrows, not you. And you can't save these. Because, you know, they're in the final battle and all. There's a lot of Ocarina of Time references in this game, including in the music, like now. Phase 3 start! And believe it or not, we somehow have Anope. I don't know where she came from, but maybe Link called her or something like that with the horse call. But basically, in phase 3 here, what you want to do is Z-target him and stay within the range so she can charge her light arrow and fire it at Ganondorf. So I'm going to get behind him and... or at least try to. I'm going to get behind him and Z-target him, and that's your cue. I mean, that's his cue to... No. Aw, where did he go? Oh, wait, there we go. Okay. Keep, just run away from me, preferably. It's kind of tricky to get the hang of this at first, though. And oh, there we go. I got him. Shoot. Go. Yes. Oh, go. And spin attack, preferably to hit him while you're across him on the horse. Charge. Yeah. Like that. That's what you want to do. Keep him in range. Get him, he's slowing down. Good. Just keep doing it. Oh no, I ran out of whipping power. Dang it. Oh, go. And shake nunchuck. Why did that fail? Oh, whatever, it worked. I mean, it worked out. Ah, that's phase 3. I told you it would just take me a little while to get the hang of it, but it's probably the easiest phase once you know what to do. But it's not over yet, of course. We have one more phase, and then it's over. He seems to be rather impressed. Indeed he is. Recognize that blade? That sword right there? That is the same executioner's sword they used to stab him through the chest. That sword apparently has some sort of special powers. Which is why his wound still stays with him on his chest. Here we go! It's epic sword battle! But I should actually show you something that's pretty funny here. Go in your inventory, and you know what I'm talking about if you know this trick before. Get your fishing rod. Cast it. Oh! You want to cast it? See that? You just distract... I mean, he gets distracted by the fishing rod. No joke. See that? Look at his head. He actually moves to watch the hook on the fishing rod. And you can beat him incredibly easy by doing that. So I'm not going to be doing that. I just wanted to show you that trick. You can do a similar jolt thing like that in Ocarina of Time by deflecting the bottles back at him. I mean deflecting Ganon's tennis balls back at him using bottles. You can do the same with Phantom Ganon in The Wind Waker, And you can also, with Demise in Skyward Sword, you may also do the same thing, but it's more of a distracting thing, like the fishing rod, as you've seen in this game, is you distract him with the bug-catching net. Nintendo sure knows how to make people laugh. And they don't take their games too seriously. I mean, the design of them, that they put in little Easter eggs like that. But anyway, battling Ganondorf, for the most part, is kind of like battling a Dark Knight, actually. So you shouldn't have all that much issue. Just make sure to pay attention to which hand he's holding the sword, and then strafe around the side that he, you know, the side that he's not holding the sword. And eventually, you're going to come to a point where you are going to be allowed the finishing move. He's gonna fall to the ground eventually. Just be ready for that. Oh, oh, oh! Then you combo attack. Oh, no, 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 roll! Whenever he jumps up in the air, roll away, otherwise he will get you. Oh, oh. On, there we go. Maybe he's a little tougher to get past than a Dark Knight, but not too much tougher. Come on. Almost done, I can feel it, oh my goodness! And great, my camera battery's running low too. It would suck to have to redo this last battle and whatnot because of that. I haven't saved since the restart of, I mean, way back at the... Oh, when you get into this point, press the A button and shaky shake! And he's vulnerable, attack him, like that. That's another way to hit him. You gotta clash swords like that in order to do so. But yeah, I think I'll have enough battery power to do this. It's a race for the battery power. I mean, it's a race to finish this part before the batteries run out. It's no big deal, really, if I have to restart up to this point. I love playing this game. But I would have to restart a pretty good segment of the dungeon, actually. It would be, all the way after the point I completed the left side of the castle courtyard. Yeah, that was the last time I saved when I quit the game earlier. But I've been playing since then. Oh, come on. Roll. Good. I still have the credits to show as well. Can't have a game finish without credits, after all. Come on, fall to the ground. Eventually, there's something, I don't know. Attack me! I could just use the fishing rod if I wanted to, but it just feels too cheap. Finish! 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 Yeah! And the game is over! Whew! That was awesome! Dang! Right through the same hole. Oh, I know it won't. You always come back. Oh, there goes the Triforce of Power. I love the way he dies, though, here. Just look at this. Not only that, he dies standing up like a statue like this. How wicked is that? Very wicked. If you didn't know the answer. Whew. But poor Midna. She sacrificed herself to try and save the world.
Or did she? Midna's okay. But she doesn't look like how she looked before. This is what she looks like normally, when she's not in that imp form. I love this line. What? Say something. Am I so beautiful that you've no words left? And then Link knew who it was. All is well. All is good in the hood. Here's the credits. Oh man! This was quite a ride, I have to say. Easily my biggest project yet, and my longest walkthrough yet. I ran into a lot of snags along the way, which is what caused the delays in parts and whatnot. But whew, this was so much fun! Would I do it again if I had the chance? Well, sure, and I felt could do it again, but why would I do a walkthrough twice unless I was like doing it in a redux fashion, so to speak, to show how much I've improved compared to what I used to do and whatnot. You get what I'm saying. But yeah, this was an amazing experience to do a walkthrough on. And again, as I said before, this is my favorite Zelda game, so I guess a walkthrough on this game was pretty much inevitable for me. I just love this game so much. It's got the humor, it's got the epicness. Very, very, very well designed. It's got it all, and that's what I look for in a game. It's also got a high amount of variety as well. And you know what I was just thinking? You know why I beat Ganondorf? It's not because I was the one destined to beat Ganondorf. Oh no, that's not it. It's because I beat Rollgol and he didn't. Well, it makes sense to me at least. I mean, Rollgol was without a doubt the hardest challenge in this game. I mean, you also gotta wonder why Ganondorf is so evil to, you know, why has his evil lasted so long? Maybe he got trolled a lot on the internet or something like that, and he's just taking out his frustrations out on people throughout time. That's a possible explanation. Oh, and people keep asking me if I'm gonna do Skyward Sword. I actually can't. The quality that I record my videos in is not high enough, and it's really hard to read the text in Skyward Sword, so that until I get a better setup, if I ever do, it's just not gonna happen, because the text, as I showed, I actually made some Skyward Sword videos a while back, some blind Skyward Sword videos of me beating a dungeon, and they were, as I said, completely blind, but if you looked at the text on that, like when the character would talk or something like that, you couldn't tell what they said. I mean, I could read it on my end, but you couldn't see it on your side, and there's a lot of dot crawl and flicker and stuff like that. I think they made the details of Skyward Sword way too fine, and it just doesn't work with the red, white, yellow composite cables. And yeah. Oh, jeez, there's zero bars on my camera. Oh, well, it's still recording. But I hope I'll be able to get this all in without having to splice in another clip to finish this off. Please hold up there, camera. I know you can do it. There's not much credits to go, actually, but... Oh man, I'm getting sick. And there's brothers and sisters all together at the fishing hole in spring, trying to figure out ways that they can scam people out of money. Roll Goal is by far their most successful business plan. And there's Yetta and Yetta having sex or something, I don't know. Okay, and maybe they're not. Well, actually, they might be, you never know. When there's hearts flying all over the place, you just never know. That's why you stay out of the bedroom, despite getting the bedroom key. You stay out of there if you know there's people in there. Unless you have express permission. Ah, the music. The music was really awesome in this game as well. I pointed that out a bunch of times throughout this walkthrough. Camera's still holding up. I know it can run off of 0 bars of battery life for a little while. It just gives you a warning, you know, that you are at zero battery. I mean, that you are at zero or getting really close to it cutting off. It's just that it says zero as a warning. Everyone's coming home. As I said, it's all good in the hood. Teaser music orchestration? What? What? What do they mean by teaser? I don't know. And these credits are longer than I thought they'd be. But that's okay. This game took a while for them to make, really. It took them, like, what, the entire lifespan of the GameCube? They planned on making this game... Oh, here we go, here's the end. They planned on making this game early on, and... Well, it just got delayed over until the Wii, and then it ended up getting released on both consoles. Anyway, yeah, it is. Yeah, and that's, as I said before, the Shadow World, it's not a bad place, it just can't coexist, sadly. Never ever! Yup. Unfortunately, we have to part. I will miss Midna. She was an awesome partner. Yeah, we'll do good. Until the next game. And there will be some other unspeakable evil that will attempt to take over the world that I will smite. It's just how things go. Well, Link will smite. You're welcome. She says as long as the mirror is around, but... Remember... She said that Xanth did not have the power to shatter the mirror. Because he was not the true... King, or I should say the true ruler. Well, look who can do it. Yep. And looks like the worlds will forever be separated. It's kind of sad, but it's how things have to be, I suppose. Goodbye, Midna. Goodbye, Twilight Realm. And goodbye, walkthrough. What? More credits? Well, I found an easy way to cut two parts together if I have to. By that black screen there. If I have to redo the final boss battle due to my camera running out of batteries or something like that. But hopefully that won't be the case. I definitely have to show all the credits, because these awesome people, they made the game, not me. I just made the walkthrough on it to help you out, as well as entertain you. I hope I successfully did that. I assume I did, if you're still watching to this part. Because otherwise, I don't see anyone having the tolerance to watch a person they don't like for this many parts. And this is one of the most beautiful games I've played, artistically, I have to say. A lot of bloom. Had to mention that one more time. But it's just the way they present everything. Everything just feels so natural. Even when you're fishing, the fish seem incredibly natural when you are, when they're gonna jump towards the hook, it just looks like a real fish going after something. If you've ever seen how fish move, like really studied how they move. Needless to say, I'm a fish lover. There's the Temple of Time. An awesome Ocarina of Time reference in itself. And that's another thing. It's just look how this place looks right here. It's not realistic per se, but it's not. It doesn't look bad at all. See, realistic graphics aren't everything when it comes to making something that looks beautiful. It's a matter of presentation and feel, basically. And apparently the Master Sword was put back into the Sacred Grove, I guess. Or, no, wait, they're just recapping. Oh, or maybe they're not recapping stuff. This could be another day of him calling Link out of his house. Does seem to be the kind of thing he would do. He seems incapable of herding goats on his own. Glad we got Ilya's memory back. Yeah, I completely forgot about the second set of credits here. That I thought the end of the credits were coming, and I was expecting to get to the big scene where Midna breaks the mirror. But I forgot there was credits after that. And that's it. Walkthrough is complete. My camera made it. Thank you so much, camera. And thank you all for watching my walkthrough and helping me out with it with your comments. I will see you in the next walkthrough. By the way, the head on the statue is fixed, so they must have got some super glue or something.